Okay, Romario, we're going to do those approaches you've just done, same conditions, same winds. But while we're here at Avimore, I'm going to take the opportunity to show you a short field departure. And yeah, we'll do a short field departure for flat configuration. The purpose of a short field takeoff is always to get airborne as quickly as possible. Might be down to the fact that the field is very wet, for example, so you want to keep the aircraft as light and off the ground as possible, or there is an obstruction ahead. So I'll demonstrate that on this departure, but essentially we're going to concentrate on crosswind work. I'm going to fly one approach and then hand over control back to you.
Okay, understood.
Okay, so we're looking for a touchdown point just after the glider and the wind chill.
Roger.
Okay, with a short field take, I will be getting this aircraft in the air, but only slightly in the air, just after stall speed. We'll stay in ground effect until speed picks up. Positive attitude, climbing away, then we start to put the flaps away once we've got good forward speed. You understand that?
Yes, I understand.
We'll go to the full flap configuration now. Control check. Elevators. So the aircraft is trimmed above the standard takeoff trim position to a positive trim position. We're on the brakes, get full power, release brakes. Aircraft's rolling. Once I've got about 40 knots, I'm going to start thinking about bringing the nose of this aircraft up about now. There's the nose. Going to stay in ground effect. We're in ground effect in the crosswind. We're picking up speed. Now we can climb away. Okay, let's go into the circuit. Right, did you understand what went on there?
Yes, I understand.
So we'll take a crabbing posture towards the mountain because the wind's trying to blow us towards the airfield. I see the airfield over the wing. I'm going to level out at 1,500. And bring the power back. Okay, ready to turn base? I'm going to make this turn quick, Romario, because I know there's a massive crosswind at the field and I don't want to get pushed too far in the turn. So this is going to be a quick turn and let's see where we are after the turn. I've got the field. Landing flap selected. And I'm really going to have to point the nose away from the runway to line up again. Speed's good. And again, right rudder deflection. Hold the quad and the touchdown. Fly another quick circuit. Okay, we're downwind again, Romario.
Roger.
Okay, let's go in. One stage of flat. Remember, this is a half flap approach. At this height, I can afford to bring the power all the way back. Left myself a bit high on this approach, but we're going to make it. Wing down to correct. Wing down to curve. And kick the rudder. Alright, Romario, make a 180 here. Give me a right-hand circuit, please.
Sharp field takeoff?
Right-hand circuit.
Do you want a short field takeoff?
If you are confident that you can do it, yeah.
Alright, I'll try.
Don't yank the aircraft up or we'll just fall out the sky. Very gently bring that nose, start bringing that nose up as you start passing 40, 50 knots and just hold the stick in the position.
Okay.
start bringing that nose up. Right. Staying ground effect. It's a lot more difficult with a 16 knot crosswind. You did good.
Left hand circuit.
Give me a right hand circuit. This is the problem you're having, you're turning too far away from the field. Keep it nice and tight. Come to a heading of 030. You've got the field 3 o'clock.
Negative, looking.
Okay, give me control. See the field off the nose?
Apron.
You have control. Position downwind. Bring the power back. Good. Trim the aircraft. Okay, Romario, look over my side, off the right wing now. You should see a clearing in the woods. You see that?
Yes.
Use that as your guide. That clearing leads to the runway. So use that to position on your base, head towards the clearing, and then use the clearing as final. You need to start using landmarks to position yourself and increase your situational awareness of where you are relative to the field. So there's one landmark for you, that clearing in the field. You're good for base now. Good. Speed's good. Right, you, this is a much better position than the last circuit you flew. When you're overhead the clearing, turn right to final. Now that's a much better circuit. Trim the aircraft up. More trim. More trim. More trim. That's it. Good. Good. Rudder deflection. Good. Okay, taxi back. Let's have another short field departure. So you can go ahead and, yep. Trim the aircraft up. Good. Make 180 there. Slow down before you make the turn as well. Right, off you go. Okay, left hand circuit, keep climbing. Right, left turn now. Trim the aircraft. Right, don't cramp too close to the field. You're getting blown back towards the field. That's good. Keep pointing the nose over there. Bit more right wing down, please. Okay, take a look at the field and then make a quick turn to base to final. So, have a look over the shoulder, get your field position and then make the turn. Make the turn. Landing flat. Come off that power. Trim the aircraft. Good. You've done this approach a few times, so you know what weight's going to push you. Left wing down and just hold steady. Left wing down, hold it steady. Trust me on this, left wing down, hold it steady. Just hold the left wing down and you'll end up on the, that's it. Go around, go around. Let's try that again. Okay, point towards the mountain again. Don't get blown towards the field. Do you know why you messed up that approach, Romario?
I was too high.
You rushed it. You were in the right position to make the turn, but you didn't descend on the downwind. Remember, just take your time and plan the approach. I'm going to tell you to turn in exactly the same place. Good. You did that on final on the last approach. Don't let the crosswind fluster you, Romario. Make the turn to final. Don't get too low. Trim the aircraft. You don't need the power on. You want 70 knots. Maintain 70 knots. Don't need any more power, just maintain 70 knots in position. If you bring the nose up, feed in a bit of power. Trim the aircraft. That's it. Left wing down. And hold. Just hold that position. Good. Right wing down. Right wing down. Level off. Left wing down. Right wing down. That's it. Good. Kick.
Too much kick.
Yeah, but we got the principle right. Okay, taxi back to the gliders. We'll put the aircraft away in the hangar. That's it for today. Can I have control, please?
You have control.
Okay, tomorrow, we're just going to go over some of the stuff we covered last year. Go back to some of the basics, straight and level flight, orientation, exercise 7, climbing, for example. And then we'll work on short field takeoff and landing as well. We're going to stay here for a while, for a few days.
Okay, Roger.
This grass field is going to be good for you. Alright, Roy, I'm going to update your logbook and send that back to you tomorrow, ready for training. I emailed you some exams this evening. I need you to get the meteorology and the air law exams done. I've sent you both FAA and Europe versions, obviously because of your crossover. I want you to try and attempt both.
Okay.
Alright, so do the answer sheet, email it back to me.
Okay, well done.
Alright, and catch you same time tomorrow, yeah?
Alright, man. Tomorrow.